We going scorch earth with this one. Can't you see what these rappers doing here? Yeah. Hey, hey. We been working on a process, yeah. And found a jewel in the conscious. Time to rule out the gossip and bruise all the sacrilegious views they've been lost in. See the truth in plain sight, camouflage. You can't hide from it. Time to oblige it. Embrace. No more distractions.
No more.
We in a crisis.
It's real.
And now the righteous clashing with the titans,
yeah.
Badgering the Vikings,
yeah.
Piercing them with tridents.
Yeah.
A deafening silence is all in the air.
Yeah.
Not a narrow path. It's now just a trail.
Small.
Get it on our own. It's what has been revealed.
Yeah.
Another broken seal.
Yeah.
Another hopeless shield that's dying on that hill. My scarf is better chill.
Chill.
I'm Holy Spirit filled, fucking going for the kill. You can't comprehend what's real, cause they feeding you with poison. The radio destroys us and convolutes our choices. Music is life, but it's death in their voices. Lust, sex, drugs, gang, violence, they done spoiled us. Music is life, but it's death in their voices. Guns, sex, drugs, gang, violence, they done ruined us.
They got us sick.
Can't you see what these rappers really doing, nigga? They making money, but they out here ruining us. Can't you see what these rappers really doing,
nigga? Yeah.
They making money, but they out here.
This the music that we need to cleanse the soul. Music industry disease. That's not a cold. You gon' need you a vaccine. Act like you know. See, the devil got a team. They forth and gold. He gon' show you a big dream. It's filled with gold. In the whip that's super clean. Oh, yeah, you know. Big booties and double D's. And she on gold. Blue seas and palm trees. Got treated blow. See, he know just what you need. Got what you want. First, he wants you on your knees. Don't even front. This is everything you dream. Let's wrap this up in order to RAP. Let's clear this up. Don't forget to add the E. Power bottoms up. Parties with Diddy. Light a candle up for some of your family. You know what's in your cup? The blood of babies. Go ahead and drink it up. That's you and never me. But don't you mess it up. A sick industry. We tryna wake you up, but now you finally see. These rappers really suck, and that's literally. They tryna gas you up, they will use your greed. Yes, a master, you a coon for white supremacy. Buck broken, you a coon on the airwaves for weed. Buck broken, you a coon. Music industry got you running towards doom.
Can't you see what these rappers really doing, nigga? They making money, but they out here ruining us. Can't you see what these rappers really doing, nigga? They making money, but they out here ruining us. What up, what up, what up, what up? Peace and blessings to everybody in the chat. Y'all know where to find that music. New Breed Universal ENT. That song is myself featuring You With Desire. And that's a fire track right there, I'm telling you. Go over there and hit that subscribe button, brothers and sisters. Yes, indeed. This stream right here is one of the most important streams that I've ever done, if not the most important stream. Welcome, everybody joining. I see everybody coming in. Trisha's in the house, Young Gene, Trey D. Man, what's going on? Chip Marks in the house. T. Douglas in the building. Abby B. I see all the moderators holding it down. Serving a Yah, Pastor Rufus is in the building. Everybody is live. Yes, all praises to the Most High. Salute to everybody watching. Now, Nation Over Religion is the title. By the way, that particular phrase is coined by my brother, You With Desire. I didn't quite comprehend exactly what that phrase meant until right at this very moment. I mean, recently, I got the idea of it. But now I understand it to another degree, another level, right? And after streaming with some very powerful brothers last night, which we'll be weighing in on that particular broadcast. After streaming with those brothers, man, you know, I've seen a lot has happened in these churches, camps, congregations, and so forth. And there was, let's see, 1, 2, 3, I believe 4 brothers that were a part of the panel who all were in churches for a great amount of time, and they've experienced what we call church hurt. You know, they were betrayed by the church, you know, disregarded, treated unfairly. And, you know, I realize that there's a vicious cycle that continues to be a problem, right, in these churches. And we got to put away religion altogether when it comes to nation building. We are a nation of people at the end of the day, brothers and sisters. Whether we're in a church, a congregation, no matter what we're doing, we are a nation of people. And it's so much that needs to be done, right? And I thought about this for a while. I thought about how could I address this situation? I said, man, should I bring a bunch of sources out and show the people the power of our dollar? You know, like just thinking about how it wouldn't be no Wall Street if it wasn't for us, let alone Black Wall Street. Let's not even go there. Let's not even talk about the $3.1 trillion that so-called Blacks are owed. Let's not even go there. I thought about all the details, all of the history, how when we were let out of slavery, how our dollar literally started the economy in America that you know today. And I thought about all these things and I said, man, should I take that direction just to show my people how powerful we are when we put our mind towards one common goal? And then I thought about it. I said, no, it's too far. It's too far gone for that. We should know all of these things. Especially when I'm speaking among the honorable mentions that were amongst the panel. I know these brothers know the history. I know they understand economics and I know they get it. And you, the people, should understand that as well. That, let me go to a scripture here. And then we're going to really get into the source. Because the scriptures tell us something that's very key in Ecclesiastes 10 and 19. And it reads, hold on, let me get this. It says, a feast is made for laughter and wine maketh merry, but moneyeth answer all things. Now, of course, we know money don't answer things of the spirit, but it's talking about all things that's tangible. It's a solution. The other nations understand that. We really need to comprehend this scripture. Because guess how a community is built, no matter how you slice it? It's money. It's resources. It's what's needed to establish anything. There has to be financing done to make this thing a reality, right? And with all the influence, all the respect, all of the admiration that a lot of brothers have, why can't we put something together? You know, and that just goes for people in general, not just the brothers on the stream. I will be reacting to that. With no further ado, let me get to this particular broadcast so we can get a greater understanding here. Absolutely. Somebody said it's a tool. It absolutely is a tool. Some of y'all probably wondering, where are you going with this, Reed? Well, you're soon going to find out. Stay tuned. Because there's been a lot of money thrown into these churches. If you look at the misappropriated wealth that we have given society, whether it's these churches, whether it's the industry, whether it's name brands, no matter what it is, we giving our money right back to the other nations. I sit up here and I watch BMF, the show BMF, and these dudes could just be shooting at each other, literally shooting at each other. And Big Meech will walk up like, yeah, man, I know we were just shooting at each other last week, but the plug done changed up. And yeah, we need to go ahead and put this bread together, and we need to go ahead and work together. But they can do that. They can do that on the streets. Do we have that in us? Is the question. Do we have it in us as so-called men of truth, men of the Most High? Do we have it in us to put resources together to make something real happen? That's what I want to know. Seriously, I seriously want to know this. I'm questioning the men of the Most High. Now, I'm going to say this now. I'm going to react to this material, and I want to let this be known off the break. I'm not here to galvanize brothers, and I'm not here to show any condemnation towards brothers, but I am here to challenge you brothers. I am here to challenge you. I'm here to challenge you. So keep in mind, you know, I'm going to keep it 100% in this video, and it is what it is, right? Let's go. And fellas, I wanted to quickly give some closing sentiments because I'm coming across some time constraints, and I wanted to say some things and just put some information out there for all the fellas on the panel. I don't know if all of you all may be aware, but we also have a land initiative development community that we're working on. Now, speaking on Dow and Straightway's influence, a lot of brothers really looked up to the communal part of what Straightway was doing. And we've been disappointed by all of this. We've seen how Brother Jamie was treated, Mr. Gonzalez, as well as Pastor Rufus. And, you know, we were discouraged for a while because we said, man, this is how communities is ran. You know, we new to this. We in infant stages of development. You know, all we got a couple wells dug. We got some generators on there. We got a couple trailers, a couple RVs. There is a livable structure there that has a lady built a small home. And one thing that we've learned through all of this is that we wanted to learn from the mistakes of these fallible men. Now, let me make this clear. Straightway didn't do everything wrong. Them having community is important. And I'm going to be 100% where everybody viewing right now. You know, Dow, he made a stream and he talked about how they have a community, how they're together, how if something was to hit the fan, then they good. And I actually agree with what he said. Regardless of how we feel about, you know, whatever extramarital affairs he got, which I'm in total disagreement with. I'm in total disagreement with how it's ran over there. I'm in total disagreement with a lot of things that's going on. The man is a cult leader, if you ask me, just to keep it, you know, straightforward, which he's the man's a cult leader and he's wicked. But with the combination of all the men that can gather, like we did last night, we're talking about well over a million subscribers combined. Well over a million subscribers combined. And that's something that we should really put into consideration. Let's go. Who want to lead and be Judas goats? And what we decided to do is kind of separate church and state. Because what we've learned is with all these religious institutions, it seems that somebody's ego is going to get in the way. And you hear what I'm saying here? It's time that we separate church and state. It's time that we separate church and state. Now, the Bible tells us, and this is straight up from Zephaniah 2, gather yourselves together, yea, gather yourselves together, O nation not desired. O nation not desired. It didn't say gather yourselves together, church. It didn't say gather yourself together, camp. No, the Most High God is identifying us as a nation of people. How can we call ourselves a nation of people if we have not even established our own town? They got Chinatown. They got the Arabs. They got a little town and all of that. But what have we officially established is the question. Have we came together as a nation of people, not with religion all out of the equation? Let's take religion out of the equation. Let's continue. Somebody is going to try. I mean, we've been doing this for centuries now, not just decades. No, our people literally have been doing the same thing. And it's true. And I want to excuse the feedback, the quality of the playback. Somebody's mic was bringing up feedback, so my voice is going in and out. But it's true. We have been falling for the same games for centuries now when it comes to these damn churches and these camps and congregation, and literally doing the same thing over and over again. That's literally insanity, y'all. It's insane, right? Let's go. And now we've came to the conclusion that it's time for Israelites to actually produce something great. We're talking about something great. Now we have access to over 117 acres of land.
117 acres.
Now, I want y'all to think about that. Black Wall Street wasn't even, I believe it was under 60 acres. Now, I want to ask a real question. Are we in a society right now where men in truth can come together for drama, but we can't come together to build something together? I just want to know. This same meeting, would it be possible for us to gather on doing something with a large portion of land with our influence? Or are we only going to gather together when there's a lot of things going on in the community? And I mean that respectfully, respectfully. I got mad respect for everybody that was on the panel, I have mad respect for everybody that was on the panel, but this is a serious question. And it wasn't about drama, but there's a lot going on. Now, the panel was about exposing what's going on in the straightway cult, as well as brothers, you know, being able to share their testimonies. But once we got towards the tail end of the discussion, now solutions need to be brought to the table. It's just a thought. Let's go. That's a lot of land. And with all these great minds on this panel, all I can think of is, man, when are we going to have our own something like a Chinatown? When are we going to have all these great minds? Shouldn't be one man eating off the people. We should all be producing, generating revenue on said land. when we gonna bring Black Wall Street back? If we're the Israelites, the Bible speak of, which we
are. People asking where the land located is located in North Carolina, very close to Myrtle Beach. All right, that's where it's located. Just for the record, for those asking in the chat, let's continue.
All right. Then what we put our hands to is supposed to turn into gold. We have the resources, we have the ingenuity, we have the wisdom. And I feel like at this time, a lot of our people, we got to be on our business. We got to be about our business.
Now, hold on. Something was said, Key. I want y'all to listen once.
You have the wisdom.
No.
And I should all be producing, generating revenue on said land. When we going to bring Black Wall Street back? If we're the Israelites, the Bible speak of.
If we the Israelites, the Bible speak of, which we are, when are we going to have our own? Now, listen, I want to go. And pretty soon I'm gonna bring your wits' eye in. Let me make sure I share the link here. And that's the link right there in case the brother, you know, needs that. I want to go to Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, because we're supposed to be the Israelites. We've been in these laws, statutes, and commandments for years upon years, right? Well, let's talk about the blessings just for a second, because there's a couple of these blessings that we don't fit right now. It tells us that in Deuteronomy 28 and 12, it says, the Lord shall open up thee in his good treasure, the heavens to give the rain unto thy land in his season, and to bless all the work of thine hand, and thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. Wait, hold on. We ain't fitting that right now. We shall lend into many nations and we shall not borrow. Now we're talking business right now. Because if we're going to be lending to many nations and not borrow, that means we're going to be in a situation where we're going to have our own, where we can have banks, gas stations, stores, community. In order for us to lend, we will have to establish those things. Now, how long are we going to be in these churches, in these camps, and be keeping the commandments, but we're not getting the blessings? Are y'all following what I'm saying here? We've been in these churches. We've been doing what we've been doing, supporting these different ministries. When are we going to be the lender and not the borrower? When are we going to get on our business? Is the question. It also tells us, the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail, and thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe, to do them all. These are the things that's supposed to happen. We're supposed to have increase. We're supposed to be the lender and not the borrower. Just something to consider. Anyway, let's continue.
Which we are. Then what we put our hands to is supposed to turn into gold. We have the resources. We have the ingenuity. We have the wisdom. And I feel like at this time, a lot of our people, we got to be on our business. We got to be about our business and establish something that's not necessarily religious based. Of course, we know who we are. We know that.
Now, understand, brothers, I need y'all to understand. We the only ones who can do this. As the Israelites, as the biblical Israelites, we are the only ones who can do this. The rapper's not going to do it for us. The actors and actresses, the entertainers, nobody's going to do this. Now, we could talk about what's going on in Straightway. We could do that. But how do we move the body of Christ forward is the question. What is the next level? Because the men that you see on that panel, and of course, it's a few others who didn't make it, but we are responsible for moving our nation forward. We are. Nobody else is going to do this for us. And I hope you're not waiting for Jesus to come gather us, because Christ himself said, gather. Christ himself told us what we need to do, gathering ourselves together, mobilizing, being like the ant, doing what we need to do. So I'm hoping we're not just, I know a lot of brothers went through a lot with the churches, but I'm really hoping that brothers don't, you know, X out more solutions. And we can sit around a round table and have those type of discussions. No doubt about that. Anyway, let's continue. The truth. We're conscious to that. We're aware of that. And of course, whoever wants to be involved are going to naturally gravitate towards that type of initiative. But, you know, in my walk, man, I visited Black Wall Street. I've been to these places. And, you know, one thing I thought about not too long ago is that even the way Straightway was ran down, he could have started a construction company, a construction business, and actually got, you know, actual grants to pay people instead of taking. So it's many ways.
Right. So what I'm trying to explain here is that there's many ways that we can generate revenue to where it's iron sharpening iron and people can actually, you know, eat, survive and live. And it's not just one man taking from the flock. It should never be that way. Anyway, let's continue.
Ways of doing certain things that we're now learning, information we weren't privy to before. But the point I want to make is, you know, I'm in hopes and I extend this olive branch to all the brothers who want to build with what we're doing here. It's not a church structure. We really just want to play.
And I see Pastor Rufus, he says that grants get you in the bed with the government. You know, there's other solutions as well. You know, we can do fundraisers with all the influence that we have, you know, with all of the brothers who were involved. You know, we can have events. There's so many ways, but what's needed is every man in truth who can see what's going on in the world, see how they're coming against our people, seeing how, you know, we're in times right now, and there's a lot going on. We need brothers just to be on one accord. If brothers is on the same page, then that's a solution in itself. But let me continue here.
Put our minds together and have somewhere that we can call our own and build, not as a church, none of that, but as the Israelites establishing their own community. It's like they got Chinatown, they got, you know, all of these different towns. We're the Israelites, and the curses are about up. And it's about time we stop falling under the dictatorship of these men who are fallible. If the head of every man is Christ,
the head of every man is Christ. And what I'm saying here is, when are we going to understand that these curses are being broke? But we have to move forward. It's up to us, right?
We should be able to deal with each other with honor, with respect, with honesty, with transparency, and all of the above. And no man is above that. And we hold each other accountable as such. And that's just something that, when you look at it, the religion and then all of that, the churches, it always stands in a way, one way or another. And I don't think it's by any chance that there's over, the following that's in here is over 1 million people.
Over 1 million people for our subscribers and following. Wow. I mean, wow. Imagine what we can do. See, we had a time where we got to be visionaries, y'all. We cannot limit the possibilities. We cannot limit our own potential. And I really hope that some of the things that, you know, some of the brothers that was on the panel, it's not to anybody directly, just so I'm hoping that what they've been through following churches and religion, I hope that, you know, that doesn't stop them from progressing how the Most High would like to see us and moving the body of Christ further and actually really going on that ascension phase and getting things done, putting, you know, really getting things done on a business perspective of everything before we even focus on residential. We got to be about our business first.
then we got to focus on residential. We got to be about our business. And we got to talk. Iron got to sharpen iron. If they can do it in the world, we definitely got to learn how to work together and make something shape. Because the capital is going to solve everything. The capital is going to get everything built up. It is what it is. Let's go. Well, Mark the message where everybody's following. Combined, it's well over a million people. We have the greatness. We have the influence. We have it all to really establish something great. And I'm hearing you brothers networking. Everybody's connected. So that's just something I wanted to bring to the forefront. And, you know, pretty soon we're going to be doing another land walk in May. And I know a lot of brothers may not be wanting to involve that because they're coming from that. But this is something totally different. This is something led by the Messiah, because the Messiah do say, gather yourselves together, O nation not desired. Gather yourselves together. And it says, plant ye garden and build. And Dow was right about that. Those scriptures are right. Although I don't believe he authentically got straight where I think he got it from R.G. Stair. A lot of the template that I've seen and researched. But the Bible is he's right when the scriptures say, build ye homes and dwell therein. Plant ye gardens and eat the fruit thereof. It's all real. We need.
See, you know how I'm not being partial. If Dow has something right, it is what it is. Because at the end of the day, Dow can sit back and say, hey, I got my community. They sitting there talking about me. At the end of the day, regardless of how y'all feel, that's just the facts. Is Dow's kingdom falling? Absolutely. Will he be judged accordingly? Absolutely. But let's make something very clear. We are responsible for moving this forward. We got the ears of the people. Dow ain't powerful. Dow don't have the influence of none of the brothers on the panel. To be quite frank with you. So while we can gather for him to be, and that's church to be the centerpiece, but can we gather? The question is, can we gather to do something else? Now, if we can't, if brothers don't want to get involved, it is what it is. I have no issue with that. Everybody, ain't no hard feelings. But I just need to notice these type of things, because I'm not the type of person that like wasting my time. Right. And I know time right now is of the essence. And I know there's things that need to be done, because regardless of what, I'm going to continue on that right path. And if I have to work with everybody on the outside, if I have to outsource with everybody, then that's what's going to happen. It just is what it is. But let's continue.
As men of the Most High, with all this influence, all this leadership, and all this wisdom, I know it's time for that. And that's just something I want brothers to kind of consider and think about. And I will yield at that. I'm definitely tuning in. This is a blessed stream. It's very powerful. And I'm glad to be amongst honorable men. The scriptures say when you doing his work, you will be and I'm paraphrasing, it's in Proverbs. When you're doing the work, you will be in the council of honorable men. You'll be around kings. And I know that I'm amongst kings, and I'm just honored to be a part of this panel here. And bless you, brother. Thank you. Thank you for allowing me to have the floor for that moment.
Absolutely.
Amen.
Peace and blessings.
If nobody asks a question, I have a question for Eric.
Before you, Brother Bob, let me say this in response to what he's saying. That's why we need to be unified in the spirit with each other. Let me put this on mute. I don't think that's coming from me. Let me see something. Okay.
Somebody that's why we need to turn on.
Yeah, I still hear that background. My mic's muted, so it's. I think it's.
It just.
And let me make this clear. You know, there was a lack of response. There was a lack of response to what I said. But it wasn't about, I wasn't saying what I said to really get a response. It was more so planting a seed. I really want brothers to start to think differently. And I know it's only been a day. And I still, you know, me reacting to this,
I still want you to think about this. Liz, ain't nobody telling you to pack up and move tomorrow. Ain't nobody telling you to invest everything you have. That's not what's being said right now. Even with this stream, I'm planting a seed. I need for us to think bigger than religion, bigger than churches, bigger than camps. We have to. And it's almost like somewhat people don't want to hear that. They don't have that. It's like a lot of people don't have that drive to want that. It's like we're getting caught up in everything else. That's something big right there. Let's continue.
It is left.
I think it's Rufus. Yeah, I think because he just muted his mic, so I think it might be him.
Okay. The scripture said it's one body and one spirit that you're called. Endeavor to keep the unity of the spirit and the bond of peace. For us to be a community, we got to share the same values. If you love one another, then will all men know you have love. If you love one another, then will all men know that ye are my disciples. The brothers need to have real love for each other. For real, man. Love don't work no.
And he's right. Brothers do have to have real love for each other. The brother responded. And brothers do have to have real love for each other. Meaning, even if it's offensive at times, if you offended, like let's use the Pastor Rufus situation for a second, right? All because Dow was offended. Pastor Rufus was dealt with treacherously. Why? Because there was no love. There was no love. There was no real love for the brother. So what the brother is saying is true. It has to be respect. Among men, love is just respect. That's it. We just got to respect each other. And we got to be in a spirit of humility. We got to put our egos to the side and not get into that spirit of preeminence where somebody's trying to run and rule over somebody. Because that's not what this is about. And to be honest, all of the brothers that's in this truth, that's doing the work, who are even interested. Listen, we nothing without each other. We all we got. At the end of the day, we all we got. The other nation's not going to just pick us up by the bootstraps. Nobody's going to help us, y'all. We can only help ourselves. So that alone, we should just have love and respect for each other, man. But let's continue.
Ill. It's stuff that went down the straight way that's going on in these groups and these camps. That ain't love. All the treachery, the trespass. A brother served you for 25 years, for 12 years, and you discard of him like trash.
Yep.
And you malign him. A brother leave his wife in your trust, thinking his family. He leaving it with relatives, and you betray him. So for us to be a community, we got to be all in the same spirit. And we got to have a code of ethics. There has to be a discipline that we operate under.
And I agree with that. And I think with a brother, I think I know where he's going with it. So I'm going to play it a little bit longer. Let's see.
And we operate under this commandment that we love one another. And these things that are abominations and that destroy communities, we will not do. We're not going to make excuses for it. We're not going to justify it. We're not going to rationalize it. We're going to live this finally. We live finally in this end stage of the end of the world. If the scripture says the husbandman waited for the precious fruit of the harvest, when are men going to see that we really need to love each other's brothers?
Yep. And the brother's right. He's right. He's absolutely right. But not many people wanted to chime in. And no disrespect, because sometimes the brothers want to think and meditate on what was said and put things into consideration. But I'm reinforcing that, yeah, I'm challenging you brothers. I'm not here to galvanize y'all. I'm not here to disrespect y'all in no way, but there's a challenge on the table. Like, yo, if we can gather for that, we should be able to gather for something even greater. And I seen Pastor Rufus in the building. He said he's definitely willing to help out, even if he doesn't reside in North Carolina. That's a blessing to hear. It's a blessing. And far as the other guys on the panel, they don't know me that well, you know. Some of the guys, I mean, Mark the Messenger, Floor Dean Rollo, you know, we know each other. That's brothers right there. But point I'm trying to make is, you know, I'm even extending that olive branch to Mr. Gonzalez, of course, as well as Elder Gabar as well. You know, I'm extending that to every brother, you know what I'm saying? And me also, we spoke behind the scenes a couple times on different things. And, you know, everybody got their olive branch. But anyway, let me continue here because I want to hear what else the brother had to say.
The Vietnamese, man, are together in their communities. Mm-hmm. And they sow together and they reap together. Why can't the brothers sow together and reap together? But in Nehemiah, here's one of the issues that was noted. Look at this right here that's noted. You can't have anybody sitting in a position of authority that ain't sanctified, or they gonna move carnal on you. They gonna move fleshly. They gonna move for their own personal gain because they're not seeking. They're seeking their own, not the wealth of another. We're supposed to be seeking each other's wealth. I want to see you successful, Brother Eric. I want to see you successful, Brother Gabar. I want to see you successful, Brother Mark. I want to see you successful, Brother Rollo. I want to see you successful, Brother Rufus. I want to see you successful, Brother Newbreed, Galvin. I want to see you successful. And I have to be instrumental. We have, as a people, we have been more of a curse to each other than a blessing. And we want to complain about what's going on. In Nehemiah chapter 7, look at what it says, right? Nehemiah chapter 7 is verse 1 and 2. Look at this. Now it came to pass, this is when they were rebuilding the temple. But note this character issue. Now it came to pass when the wall was built, I had set up the doors and the porters and the singers and the Levites were appointed. Then I gave my brother Hanani and Hananiah, the ruler of the palace, charge over Jerusalem, for he was a faithful man and feared God above many. See that? He was a faithful man and he feared God above many. Meaning he had more integrity than other people. He had more compassion than other people. He was more trustworthy than other people. So to be in a family and to be leading in a community, you got to have more integrity. You got to fear God above many in order for you to operate in the productivity and the success of your people. And that's why they tell you about Christ. It said the fear of God was upon him. Some men hear what the scriptures say, but they're not scared to transgress it. And then who do you hurt? You hurt your own brother. You hurt your own community and you wound souls. So we need to come together. But the scripture says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things shall be added. Even in corporations, there are bylaws. Mm-hmm. That you trust, you break those bylaws right there, you out the corporation. So there's rules that govern every action. And if we will submit to a certain set of rules, then we can profit here and in the next world, in the next life. Go ahead.
Yeah, now what he's saying is real. We do have to have a code of conduct, ethics. And a lot of people want to know what's the difference between the community that we're setting forth and just a regular community out there in the world. Well, the difference would be it's being spearheaded by the children of Israel, of the Israelites. But we're just not doing it in a vein of religion. That's not to take away rules and regulations. Every community have rules and laws that you got to live by. So just to clarify that, and that brother is speaking some truth, but every community got to have rules, regulations, and guidelines, right? With no further ado, I'm going to be bringing in Elder Yewitaza.
Good to be here. Appreciate you having me, New Breed.
Absolutely, family. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yeah. It's good to have you in. And this discussion right here is, like I said at the beginning, man, it's one of the most important streams that I'm putting out there. I don't expect it to be the most popular, but it's the most important. Right. But man, and I definitely know you got a lot to add to this when it comes to these churches and nation over religion, because first of all, you coined that phrase. And what does it mean to you?
Man, nation, you know, as far as nation is concerned, I understood this one thing is that, and this is as far as back as I can remember, as a little kid, whatever little bit of history that I got and understood, I knew that our people was taken from our homeland and brought over here on slave ships. That's the one thing that I knew.
Right.
And when they took us from over there and brought us over here, that was another nation. That was a foreign nation taking us as a nation and bringing us over here. And when they brought us over here, they brought us over here and gave us their language. They gave us their culture. They gave us their religion. They gave us their gods. They gave us, they forced upon us all of the things of who they were. And they completely stamped out and erased whoever we were. Now, when I say whoever, I want to make it clear, at the time when I knew that our ancestors was dragged over here from their homeland, they were dragged over here as a nation from their homeland. They were one nation. We had all of our own things. Okay? Now, good, bad, right, or indifferent, we understand what the scripture says about why we ended up over here in this captivity and spread all across the four corners of the earth. But we had something. Okay. And this particular nation that we're under right now has completely erased that away from us, so much so to the point that by the time our ancestors went through the transatlantic slave trade, and then they underwent the lynching, the Willie Lynch letters. When a lot of people talk about the Willie Lynch letters, and they understand that there was a method to completely erase away from us our identity, okay? And there's a scene from the movie Roots, right, where you have Kunta Kinte, and they have him strung up along a tree, tied up along the tree, and then they have the so-called master there, and then they have whatever slave there that he's using to whip Kunta Kinte, right? Mm-hmm. And as he's whipping Kunta Kinte, he's telling him that make sure that you let me know what your name is. And he want Kunta Kinte to say, my name is Toby, right? But every time he whips Kunta repeats, my name is Kunta Kinte. So he was not going to allow that to be just ripped away from him. He was fighting tooth and nail to keep who he was. But by the time Kunta Kinte was taken down off of that tree, Kunta Kinte tried to run because his whole mentality was to get back home, to get back to his nation.
Right.
Right. That was his whole mentality. His mentality wasn't to stay here and get comfortable and get a job and start a family and then just live your life happily ever after, just as long as master don't come down and bother you. That wasn't his mentality at all. His whole mentality was to get back home. Yo, do y'all know they cut this man's feet off and this man was still trying to run back home? Right. Yep. So after his generation, it only took two generations, yo. Mm-hmm. It only took two generations for his children's children to get so comfortable that their minds was completely brainwashed to the point where they thought, now I'm an American. Right.
Right.
And whatever they were as a nation, whoever they was, all of that was forgotten. They remember their dad. They remembered their father enough to write a book about him, you know, in the book Roots. But everything else was forgotten. So when I think about nation, when I think about us as a nation, that's what I think about. I know and understand that we are still a nation. No matter if we have assimilated into another nation, we are still a nation. That's what we are. The Almighty Yah had established us as a nation. It's right there in the Bible. So despite whatever they told us and whatever they forced upon us, we are still the nation. We are the nation of Yisrael. That's who we are. And ain't nothing that we could say or to change that. It is what it is.
Absolutely.
So when it comes down to religion, okay, religion has become a pseudo identity for us. Okay. Our people have utilized religion, because honestly, that was the only comfort that we had away from the tyranny from these monsters, these sick monsters that have oppressed us. You got to remember during slavery time, mm-hmm. that the church was the only place that they can go and sort of just be themselves.
Right.
The slave master allowed that, and the reason why he allowed that is because he created a new book for them. He created a slave version Bible for them, and they utilized whatever they could utilize. But as soon as they got some of those other books, they started opening their eyes. That's how you get people like Nat Turner.
Right.
And the insurrections of Nat Turner. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because Nat Turner had realized the same thing that we realize today. Oh, snap. We the Israelites. We're a nation of people, and this is a foreign nation over us that has oppressed us. We have to break free.
Yep.
And so when it comes down to this whole the whole religion thing, we have utilized this as a pseudo-identity because it's really the only identity that we have that allows us to reconnect with something that is beyond our oppression. It's allowing us to reconnect with our original power, which is Yah. Okay. Right. And that's the reason why they're not able to break us down. They're not able to tear us down, but they are able to do this one thing, control us.
Right.
They are able to control us through religion.
Absolutely. That's just.
And so it has to be nation over religion, because Yah didn't put a religion into captivity. I don't remember that in the scriptures at all. Yah didn't select a religion to go through this captivity and all of these curses. He didn't select that. He select a nation of people, and that's who we are. So if we identify that it's our nation that has to be healed.
Yeah, absolutely. And
that's what has to be healed. Go ahead.
Absolutely. And let me clear up something in the chat.
Yeah.
Listen, because I want everybody to be focused, right? Now, publicly, I've stated that I believe that Tao, and I hate to go sidestep, but I need people to focus real quick. He's 100% been proven to be in adultery. All right. And that's just what it is. All right. Now, I see everybody attacking and questioning and Pastor Rufus and all that. That's not about that. Pastor Rufus just made it very clear that he has successfully created, well, how many communities? Is it 12, 13, something to that effect? So regardless of disagreements, that if Rufus doesn't see it that way, that's him. That's him. You understand? I see it that Pastor Dow is an adulterer. But I would not let something that small divide me from getting the wisdom that I can get from Pastor Rufus. And let me point that points to a big problem too, in my opinion, because there's knowledge and wisdom that I can gain from this man. There's certain things that we can gain from each other as brothers, regardless over things that we may or may not disagree with or agree with, right? That's logic. That's logically thinking right there. When you go to a workplace, right? There's people with all kinds of different religions, different ideas, different thoughts. You're going to have agreements and you're going to have disagreements. But it doesn't stop us from getting something done, though, does it? When we at work, by the time we clock out, is the job not done? Does the ends justify the means? And this is what we deal with in religion as well. It's a certain thought process that we have that if we don't agree with somebody 100% with their doctrine, there's things tangibly that we can get done, but we're not getting it done. Why? Oh, that person believe in the new moon Sabbath. Oh, that person believe in this. This person believe in that. Right. And guess what? Nothing gets done. So I this is when we talk about nation over religion. We need to understand that, man, we got to get past certain things, right? So I don't want nobody getting distracted with the Tao situation at all.
in the chat. It's already been established. Ringo TV put out a lot of information on Dow and his extramarital affairs, his adultery, because it's adultery. It's adultery. And listen, you can look at Eric's testimony from last night. It's clean cut and dry. Right? It just is what it is. Because I know a lot of people in the chat, they're like literally thrown off by that. But of course, Pastor Rufus was there. But nonetheless, we see the situation for what it is. We may disagree. Pastor Rufus may disagree with what I'm saying right now. But should that stop Pastor Rufus for wanting to build with Breed? No. Do y'all get what I'm saying? Like, y'all got to get out of y'all feelings. If I can learn whatever I can learn from Pastor Rufus, I want to learn. I never did a community. He did 12. I mean, wait, not that I'm mixing him and Gabbard, but he successfully ran Georgia's. Right. Same thing goes for Gabbard. Gabbard might not agree with everything I say, but guess what? I want all the wisdom on how he started 12 churches, because that means he can organize. I want to learn. Religion got to be out of the way, man. That's the point. Now, and the brother said he's willing to share. All praises to the Most High for that.
Right.
Now, Elder.
Yep.
Man, so what do you believe is the hindrance with our people? Like, I got to ask you this. Like, what? Now, it should be clear cut and dry that the Most High, he made us a nation of people.
Right.
Okay, so he says he developed 13. I've helped develop 13 communities, Southwest. Straightway has none before I came. Okay, got you. So he pretty much built those communities, right? So this is what we need. But anyway, when it comes to our people, yeah, what is the hinder? What is the blockage here? What is the blockage where we can't build? Is it all religion, or do you believe it's just something, personal things? Explain the psychology behind it a little bit more. Elaborate a little bit more on it, because you did touch on how we was in the churches, and that was our only place of freedom and peace.
Right.
Now that the churches are crumbling right before our eyes, what is it now?
Man, we getting to see prophecy unroll right in our face, and, you know, we're not able to really take the necessary actions to prepare ourselves for what is to come. And it's because we completely paralyzed by religion. That's one of the reasons why. But it goes beyond that. And I want to first, I didn't get a chance to just say shalom to all of the brothers and sisters in the chat. What up, y'all, man? I'm your with this eye, man. Y'all, some of y'all already know me here. Big shout out to my brothers, man, Brother Rollo that did that stream yesterday. He facilitated that stream. That was a big man move right there. Bring the brothers to the table and, let's talk through these things so that the people could be able to understand how we going to need to move from here on out. Rollo did a great job along with yourself, Brother Mark the Messenger, Elder Gabbard, Brother Rufus. You know what I'm saying? These brothers are exposing the fact that, this religious institution is really not the way. It ain't the way. It has created a way, but it's literally using the template of something that's already sick. Is already sick. So, but to get back to your question though, Bree, the real problem is that our people have not had anything and haven't built anything of our own for the last 400 years. For the last 400 years, we've been in this captivity and we don't have any idea what it takes to have world responsibilities. We have zero idea because it's been taken away from us. And so what we are the byproduct and the children of a nation of people that operated as a nation. Now, when our ancestors were brought here, they had a nation, but we are the byproduct and the children of a people that was all beat out of, and they literally used our ancestors to build this place up. Now, for everybody that's saying that we can't build, that we're not able to build, mm-hmm. until Christ returned, you know, whatever, however that got into your mind. I know how that got into your mind.
And Let's bring it out.
Free from that is really hard. But this is the facts. We built this nation.
Yep.
And every other nation around the four corners of the earth, we built. Okay. So, you know, that with the exception of a few other nations here and there, but our ancestors built these nations. And then what in turn happened is they beat that will out of you to the point where you don't even believe that you able to go build a couple of houses on the land without Christ returning. Right. You know, but yet you're able to go fill out an application, right? See, because this is the mentality. When you really try to line this up and think about this, y'all, you're able to right now go fill out an application, a contract with your oppressor, right? And he will give you a job. Maybe your job is sticking and framing. That right there is when you're building a house where you got the framework, you're doing the framework, you got a job. You'll sit there and build the house. You'll sheetrock the house. You'll do all that stuff, right? And you'll build a whole entire community for somebody else under the auspice of some other nation, some other corporation, with some other entity, but you believe that you can't do it, right? Here's what else that we do. We got people that believe that we can't even have farms and gardens and agriculture, right? Because we cursed and we're not able to do that. It's not going to happen until Christ come back. And yet we are financing the infrastructure for the agriculture of this country.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm going to tell y'all something. My family, for those that know a little bit about me, my family, we're beekeepers. We raise bees, okay? Mm-hmm. In our backyard, we have close to 20 beehives. And in each beehive, there's like 100,000 bees. Now, for some of you, that might be like, yo, man, that's amazing. So-called black people are beekeepers. This is what's messed up about this thought. We started beekeeping here in the United States.
Yep.
It was us. And just think, if my family can grow raise bees in our backyard, 20 hives in the backyard, if more brothers and sisters came together and do that, then we have a commodity now that's actually worth something on a global scale. And we're not just offering something that is cosmetic. Hey, look, I make t-shirts. Not saying anything wrong with people that make t-shirts, you know what I'm saying? But it's cosmetic. Society don't actually really need it in order to operate infrastructurally.
Right.
Okay. And so when we get to the question of what's the problem is that a lot of our people got so caught up into religion, and they actually have got into a mindset, the same mindset of the synagogue of Satan, and they're not able to break free from that to even have any level of progress and it is like, are we afraid of progress? I don't think we are, because I'm working with a woman right now who's a ex Black Panther. She just built an $87 million property with over 70 units for low income families. How did she do it? She went out there and raised the money. I just built her website. Mm-hmm. I'm working with this woman. And you know what she said to me? That our people don't want to educate themselves, and they don't want to do the work. They don't want to do the work. They basically we lazy. That's what this woman, Elaine Brown, said to me. I talk to her almost every day. So it's not that we can't do it. It's just that we won't do it unless it's going to be the way that some religious person say that we got to do it. Oh, right. No, we can't build no community unless we all under the same church unless we all believe the same exact way. I don't see nowhere else on this planet that operates like that.
Absolutely. And you know, I just wanted to add some visuals while we're discussing this, because,
sure,
you know, we discussed this earlier about, you know, putting something out there as a vision to what unlimited potential farmland will look like after everything is done. And you said something very pivotal
and you said, well, we need to sit around a round table to see what that's going to look like. And I think that showing the land once again from this land walk perspective, everybody can, everybody's imagination who was in the stream last night can actually visualize the possibilities, the potential, because it's there, it's available. And I think that's important that we are visionaries moving forward, you know, not putting limitations on what we can do and how great this thing can be. So we call it unlimited potentials for a reason, because it's up from here. I'm going to play a little bit of this here. I'll fast forward through certain parts, but let's just get to it.
Right now I'm standing in the midst of about 25 acres of land. As you can see, it's very vast.
Now this is about 25 acres. Now throughout the trees, that all that land is ours too. But of course, we're going to have to do some mowing down trees and things of that nature. It's all 117. So maybe I should play it from the beginning so y'all can hear that.
And I'm standing right here in Unlimited Potential Campgrounds. And as you can see, our brothers and sisters showed up. Got the tents out, got the RVs out. We have been having a wonderful time. And I'm just basking in the moment, because right now these are the humble beginnings. And we have.
Now, I just want to show just
clean water. And this is because of y'all's charitable contributions through the Love Note system.
Nope.
A month ago, and they planted some spearmint. As you can see, you got some spearmint here.
The spearmint right here, right?
Yep, that's the spearmint.
So I'm just showing the people, these are the humble beginnings.
Several humble.
Yeah. And it's growing every day. So
right,
you know,
and we need to put like it's there, it's available. That's I just wanted to show the people, bro. Like it.
Yeah, and I even have a clip as well. And
yeah, you can send it through the private chat if you like.
Yeah, I'm actually gonna, if you add it to the screen right now.
Oh, okay, cool.
And you know, like just right off the gate, I just want to express to everybody that. You know, this is the person that purchased the land. And as you can see, it says 107.5 acres, but it's actually more than that. Okay. Yeah. But the person that purchased the land, you know, this brother, he's not somebody that would consider himself a Hebrew Israelite, because he understands that that's just a religion. Right. But what he identifies as is somebody that is conscious and somebody that wants to be able to live disconnected from this here system. That's who he is. So this brother, when we connected with him, he didn't care all about what our religion was. He didn't ask me not one time or what's your spiritual beliefs.
Right.
Not one time did he ask me that when myself and my cousin Elijah went and met with him on the land. Not one time. He just said, come and put your feet on the land. And if you feel like this is a good place for you, then you are welcome here. That's what this man said. The man that you see in that picture right there, that's what he said. He welcomed all of us. I let him know that we have a whole nation of people, that we have brothers that got YouTube channels with over 100,000 subscribers, over 500,000 subscribers. And many of the people do not want to be attached to this here system. These are like-minded people that want to disconnect and live a self-sustainable lifestyle. He said, if this here works for y'all, then y'all are all welcome. That's what the brother said. And that's how he feels still to this day. So when it comes down to what it is that, you know, we're talking about doing, as you can see, this right here is talking about something that's solution-based. We're not here to build another church with y'all and to preach to y'all. Everybody in here know where a YouTube channel that you can go to right now, that you can get all of the Bible studies that you want to get all day long. But I tell you this one thing that you're not going to get from that church. You more than likely not going to get no community out of it. You're not going to get no hospital out of it. You ain't getting no schools out of it. You're not getting no supermarkets out of it. You're not getting any your own water municipality out of it. You're not getting anything that is the infrastructure of a community. That's what I could tell you. So that just means that, okay, yeah, if you decide that you want to go to church, you want to be a part of a religious community, but you're going to also have to figure out where you're going to live. And as you know, Brother New Breed shares on his channel that these communities that we are living amongst, this here beast that we're living amongst right now, is getting to a point where we know for sure that it's not going to be sustainable for us. They are making things 5 times more expensive than it was, you know, just 5 years ago.
Right.
You can't get a house now for under $300,000. You can't get a house. I mean, nothing decent, at least.
Let me run that back, man. But yeah, absolutely.
I just wanted to say this one last thing. I see a lot of people saying, like, yeah, you know what? We can just all raise a dollar. Yo, you all are absolutely correct. And we've shared that on this channel before. New Breed has been actively trying to do fundraisers here through his channel. For over a year now. Okay. And so it's just about where our attention and our focus is at. Are we going to continue on focusing on the problems, right? Every single problem that come up, and then those videos on YouTube skyrocket with views, right? Or are we going to put our focus and attention and say, you know what? This whole entire system is a scam, and we're going to have to band together to put our own focus on our sustainability as a people until the Most High comes back. It's real basic and simple. So all the videos that you're seeing, all these clips that you're seeing, this is my real life. This is my real life. Everything that you're seeing here, this is the work that we've been doing. Mm-hmm. And we just asking people to come and join us. Come be a part of it. But what we need is for our brothers out there that they have large platforms. Let's gather the people together. Let's do a fundraiser. Let's do events on the land.
Yep. And that's what need to be done with all the influence that a lot of the brothers have. You know, we just extending that olive branch to be a part of it. And, you know, it's needed in this day and age, not to mention what's happening in the world. And I want to kind of hone in on that for a little while. What's actually happening in the world that, you know, we need to become more self-sufficient. Like pretty soon, you know, and I hate to just get dark and morbid with y'all, but I'm a realist. The mark of the beast gonna be here. Can I speak to y'all plain and simple? Can I keep it a buck with y'all? Can I keep it 1,000? Like, there's things happening in the world where they're implementing certain laws. There's things on the books. There's warfare, biological warfare, chemical warfare. The food is being poisoned. And listen, we can talk about that as a problem all day. But let's be 100% about this. Can we be proactive, or do we remain stagnant? Do we continue dwelling on the problems, or do we be like the ant and gather ourselves together and prepare for what's coming? Right. There's a movie that just came out called Civil War not too long ago, where they pretty much are foreshadowing pretty much everything that's about to take place. How different states are going to succeed and become like different countries where they're literally going to war with each other. If they're not creating that environment right now through predictive programming, I don't know what people looking at. And I'm not, and of course, this is no way, in no shape or form, what they would call or label fear mongering. But the fear of the Most High is the beginning of all wisdom. Through obedience to Him, that's how we secure ourselves, through obedience. It's more about obedience than fear. So I just thought I would just bring that out, man, and we gotta move accordingly. Now I got more questions for the elder. I just wanted to add that input.
Yeah, can you add this other thing on the screen?
Absolutely.
Yeah, this here is a mock-up of the kind of community that we can have. So as you can see, these right here are yurts. Okay, you can look these up. They're called Mongolian yurts. But they're not just built in Mongolia, obviously. These are glamping, livable structures all over the world. They're very affordable, you know? Mm-hmm. I mean, look, this one over here even got a little pool, You know what I'm saying? You could hook these up any way that you want to hook them up and just enjoy your life. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, this right here is not going to cost you $300,000 to build.
Nope.
This right here will cost you under $20,000 to build.
Yep.
Right? And you could have something like this on the land and just be out there chilling and stack your money up. Stack your money up, right? And then go buy your own land if that's what you choose to do. You see what I'm saying? Or you could just sit out. You could just be out here and be out here as long as you want, right? So this, we're not talking about building some church community. That's not what we're talking about. It's free land open for you to come and build a livable structure on. Save your money up. I mean, for those of you that you just work online, right? You just work remotely. This is perfect for you, right? Because now you're not worrying about paying a monthly rent. Okay. You're not worrying about paying some monthly rent every single month. You're not worrying about paying a whole bunch of utilities. You know, at most your monthly spending is probably going to be, you know, $5,000 to $1,000, depending on how you want to live. That is your choice. How much utilities do you want all up in your have your stuff all hooked up? You know what I'm saying? You know, if you somebody like Newbree, you're going to be spending pretty good, because he's going to have the internet. He's going to have all the lights. You know what I'm saying? He's going to have his stuff hooked up.
And you know that. Yep, absolutely. And so to make it clear, we want a section for Mongolian yurts. We want a section for small homes. We want a section, even an RV lot.
That's right.
But we want it to be organized, nothing that's looking crazy out here. You know what I'm saying? Right. We're talking about it's going to be clean. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And that's the vision, because you can build homes too. You can build larger homes. It's so much space and opportunity. And I need people to understand that the vision is limitless, because some people looking at the yurts, and that's a start. And like,
it's the start.
Yeah, that's a start. And like what Desire said, man, this is under $20,000 we talk. My yurt is actually on the way, and it's going to end up being our yurt in the future, because what I need the people to see is something actually being built that's livable, that it can be done. So I'm going through the process to show you the people that when is it supposed to get? About May? I think it's May 15th.
Yeah.
May 15th.
I saw the videos of it. I mean, it looks amazing. They did a good job on it. And once it gets here, we're going to go ahead and build that thing up. And that thing will be up before the summer kick in. So, you know, I mean, I want to say this, Bree, like, you know, you kept saying, you know, the people are going to have to see it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And, you know, maybe that's really is what it's going to take at the end of the day. You know, we don't, you know, like I was saying to you earlier, I'm not here trying to be, you know, some architect. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to be, you know, some engineer or something. You know what I want to just be able to stick to doing what I know how to do. I know how to gather people together. I know how to show people a vision. You know what I'm saying? I know how to do community gatherings, things, events, things like that. I want to just be able to stick on doing that, and then we can go ahead and find the brothers out there, the professionals out there that build communities. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
That's really what they're all. That's all there is to it. And like you said, you know what I mean, it may just take for our people to be able to see it and realize, like, yo, there's no coat there. You hear me, Bree? They're gonna be looking around like, wait a minute, where's the coat at? Where's the leader of the land? Is this like, what you talking about, bro? You stop being weird. Right. You know,
real tough.
Go barbecue or something. What are you talking about? We chilling. And you know, so I can't wait till we be able to get to that point where people start walking around and they realizing like none of those institutions exist there. And if there are a group of brothers and sisters that want to sit down and do some Bible studies, you're free to go do that. Nobody's coming and telling you, hey, you're gonna have to put your whole thing under my ministry. Nobody's telling you that.
You know? Right, absolutely. And that's just real talk. And it ain't no one man running some church or camp, or it's not like that. We're literally trying to design, you know, livable structures for for people who just like-minded, people invest, potential investors, if you're interested, if you can, you with desire, give, you know, ways that they can reach out and get involved. Because I know a lot of people do want to get involved and they may not know how to go about it. So if we can share something in the chat.
I want to just stress this. The way I got involved in this, the way New Breed got involved in this, we see an opportunity and we just decided to go ahead and start making a move. Mm-hmm. That's just as plain and simple. This is not rocket science, family. Now, for those of you who, you know, who may be coming forward and saying, well, what can I do? Or how can I do this, that, and the other? I just want y'all to know, like, when you ask us that question, what you're essentially doing is asking us to lead the way for you. And what we are looking for is people that are interested in leading themselves to the water. Now, we could show you where the water is at.
Yep.
We could show you. That's all I've been doing for over a year. There's 115 acres of land is open and ready to go. What do y'all want to do? And people literally come, well, how do we do it? And where is the mock-ups? Where is the blueprints? And you show me. Give me a blueprint. Can somebody come with a blueprint and say, hey, this is what I want to do on the land? I will take you over to where the guy that purchased the land, and we will sit down, look at the numbers. If somebody could say, hey, yo, I do fundraisers. We could help y'all raise $1 million for this project overnight. Mm-hmm. Let's get it. Let's go. There's nobody that's leaders here. It's just free open land ready to go. And it's like, what are we talking about? You know what I'm saying? It's like, so honestly, New Breed has put together infrastructure on his website, newbreed.love, which you can go to that website and get involved if you choose to get involved with the building, with the building project, right? We have multiple websites. We got givetoreceive.love, where you can give investments to the website, and a portion of those funds can go towards building efforts. But y'all got to understand, like, there's a lot that goes into this.
Yeah,
there's a lot that goes into this. So, you know, that's all I would say on that. You know what I'm saying? Like, honestly, I just want to see, you know, brothers like you, Breed. You know what I mean? You know, Ringo, brothers like Mark the Messenger, brothers like Rallo, you know what I'm saying? Pastor Rufus, all of the brothers that know what's up. Y'all know what's up, man. Let's just start really showing and directing the people to something that is really going to be to our benefit.
A big portion of land is tangible. That's something that
is there already.
Yeah, as Israelites, we're supposed to be agricultural people, right? And this is something that we should all have some type of connection with. Like, yo, this got to be the way right now. It got to. Right. If we're being in the spirit of moving forward and getting things done, this has to be the direction to go at the moment. Because as you can see, the Most High is doing something different. The reason why Straightway is getting torn down like the way they are is because of the sins of that fallible man who's running the cult. And everything is trickling down and a lot is being exposed, right? But it's happening for a reason, because simultaneously, while these things are happening, you know, we're seeing a different direction. This is the end of the church. The church era is over. You can, like Elder Yewitt, as I said earlier, you can go online and find any YouTuber who's preaching a ministry, they're sharing scripture and all of that. It's literally over. It's over for the churches. It's over for religion. The Most High truly wants nation over religion. He wants us to consider ourselves a nation, and he wants us to move appropriately. We got to be about our business. Put your feelings to the side.
Right. We do it every day, though. That's the thing, Bree.
We do it every day with everybody else.
We're doing it on this platform right now. Who owns YouTube? Do anybody here know who owns YouTube? Who owns Google? We on here building and working, and every time y'all skip one of those ads, Yeah, Brother New Breed is able to get a couple of dollars out of that, right? But y'all really know who getting rich. It's the owners of YouTube. It's the owners of Google. They the ones that's getting rich off of this. And what do we have at the end of the day? Yeah. And I was, Breed, remember I was just saying to you earlier, like, you know, a lot of our people talking about, yo, you know, we need to be able to own something. We need to be able to own it. And while all that sounds good, when you own it, do you even know what to do with it? Do you even know how to make sure that your children's children are going to be able to have that, have ownership over that? It's a lot of brothers right now that got massive YouTube channels, right? But after they die, who their YouTube channel going to? Who's watching your YouTube channel? Mm-hmm. Nobody. Nobody's watching your YouTube channel after you die. We don't, we're not making a plan for the future. You know what I'm saying?
They'll do you like Kevin Samuels. We don't know who got Kevin Samuels' IP, but they got it and they making bread off of it.
They sure is. And I would say none of his kids is probably making nothing off of that.
Nothing.
This is the mentality. That's what I was talking about earlier. Cosmetic. That's straight cosmetic. A YouTube channel is the surface. It's the surface, it's not the infrastructure. Yep. You see what I'm saying? And that's the thing. We haven't focused on building any infrastructure that's going to last, you know, for the generations. I see people in the chat. They like, yo, where's the lawyers at? Where's the paperwork at? Listen, we behind the scenes, we got lawyers, we got paperwork, but the real thing that we don't have capital.
Yep.
So how you gonna go talk to a lawyer? And you ain't got capital. And the lawyer like, well, you got over 1 million subscribers. Can you just do a fundraiser? Yeah, we can. But, you know, okay, well, what's the problem? You know, the people want to do church. Like, well, maybe you should open the church. No, we don't want to do that.
That's exactly what they want us to do. Y'all go ahead and start another church. And you know, go ahead and do that. Because the system, though, was keeping us in bondage and binded. And it's the churches. But a community, listen, I remember going to Black Wall Street and I didn't even know why the Most High sent me out there. Like literally something one day was like, yo, you got to go to Black Wall Street. It wasn't even something I was even thinking about. Like what? And I made content out there, but I learned something being out there, something very valuable. Just hearing their plight and hearing what they've been through in Black Wall Street and the fact that there was still business owners out there. And they were still like stuff handed down through families, even though they did what they did, bro. They still had something established. Believe it or not, they're on Black Wall Street. And that stood out to me. And this was in the midst of COVID. So while all these other people all around the world are losing small businesses, losing storefronts, while all of that anarchy was going on and all of these riots and things was going on, the business owners of Black Wall Street were still there. I'm like, yo, how is this? It's almost like they done been through what they've been through, so they know how to withstand.
Yeah.
And that's what I got for it. Now I propose this question. Haven't we been through enough as a whole that we should be able to withstand? I mean, haven't we been through enough? Right. And the fact that the rappers, the actresses, the entertainers, they're not building this for us. Ain't nobody going to do this for us. If the men of Israel can't do it, can't nobody do it. Can't nobody do it. Because I know I've heard people say Black Wall Street ain't been built back. Black Wall Street is back, believe it or not. But it's only a line of stores. It's not even that much acreage.
And but you know what's deep, bro? A lot of people don't talk about this, but after Black Wall Street was bombed and destroyed through the massacre that they had, do you know our people went and rebuilt that joint right back up? And like within 2 years, it was right back up?
Yep.
And what was deep about it is it wasn't until integration, you know, desegregation and the civil rights movement did that community start to fall apart. You know why? Because all of the people that had no other choice but to contribute to their community decided to leave their community so that they can go and be a part of more affluent white communities. They just left. And all of their capital, all of the intelligence, the knowledge that they had, they took all of that with them and gave it away to other nations. And that is what essentially destroyed Black Wall Street is that we left.
Yep.
And we just abandoned it. And that to me is the perfect analogy when you think about Israel. If you look at the house of Israel, it's really just an abandoned house because we all left our post and the work that we're supposed to be doing, and we instead focused on building up everybody else's house.
Right.
You know,
that's exactly what we did. And you know, and I know a lot of brothers been through a lot in these churches, camps, and congregations. And
yeah,
but nonetheless, the scriptures still tell us to gather. We still got to gather, man. And that's the thing about it. Matter of fact, the scriptures tell us in 1 Thessalonians 5:11 says, wherefore comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also ye do. So, you know, we can't forsake the assembly. We still got to assemble. We still got to mobilize and do what we need to do. Although it's the death of the church era. The church era is so over. It's over. It's done. But we still can't lose sight of the mission. Like, we still got to be able to gather, because I'm telling you, and I said this once and I'll say it again. I'm going to say it just like this, man. Man, I done lost my train of thought. Let me hit my laugh track for that. But now, realistically speaking, it's been a lot of streaming going on, y'all.
Yeah. But
I'll say this once again, though. We all we got.
Right.
We literally all we got. It's no other direction that we can go. These people not going to do this for us.
Yeah, I love when you keep saying that nobody else is going to do it for us. Like, who else job is this? Like if your father leaves the home and the family's not able to eat, the stuff is falling apart. The lights is flickering. You know, the doors is falling off. Is it really that we really got to a point where we just looking to see, okay, well, dad is not home. We expect another man to come into this house and fix it. Right. That's what's really sad, man. It's like,
exactly.
We got to a point where it's just like, we're just cool with leaving the house the way that it is and expecting, I guess, Biden to come and fix it. You know what I mean? It's like, it's not cool. You know what I'm saying? If we keep saying that we're the children of the Almighty God, we certainly don't act like it by the way our actions, because we don't take care of our house. We don't. We may take care of our houses individually. You know what I'm saying? I know a lot of brothers and sisters out there got beautiful homes, but us as a nation of people, as a collective, have we taken care of the house of Yisrael? We haven't. And we know that the house of Yisrael is the body of Christ. We know that, right? Have we taken care of that, or have we neglected it and only focused just on ourselves? You know, that's really what's been happening here. But I had something else I wanted to show up on the screen if you...
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I see it there, yep.
Yep. And this is this, you know, for some of the people that's been asking, like, well, where's the plan? You know, where's the paperwork and things like that. I mean, we have this here document is just one of a couple documents that we've created to try to raise money for the land, okay, from potential investors. So it's called Unlimited Potential Farms and Kingdom Resorts, okay? And so, you know, there's an opening letter there that we sent out to some people, but you can see from the table of contents, I mean, this is 17 pages right here. The problems that we seek to solve, comprehensive solutions, revenue building opportunities, phases of implementation, right? Invitation to transform the future. What are we focusing on? We're focusing on fixing housing vacancies, home ownership, right? You know, even when it comes down to education. So we have focused on, you know, breaking this down paperwork wise so that we can easily take this somewhere and say, hey, can we get an investment? And there are individuals out there that will invest in this, but you basically just signing a contract once again with someone that they'll be willing to give you the money, but now you pretty much a slave under them. Now you're a slave to the bank. Now we don't want to go that route. You know, what we're saying is do we have brothers and sisters amongst us that we can all put in together, and we don't have to deal with the bank? Because the one thing that we don't want is the bank owning all of the assets on the land.
Right.
Okay. And you just paying the bank off and thinking that you own something. You the bank owns it. Most of us talking about ownership, but the real reality is the bank own your house. Yep. And you're not going to be able to pay off your house until basically when you almost dead and gone.
Exactly.
And is your kids really going to get your house? Let's be real. Do you even know how to make sure that your kids get your house when your house got liens on it, when they got property tax on it, when it's opportunities for development companies to just come and take your property? Did you even get your trust together? Your right. family trust. You feel what I'm saying? Like, these are all the things that us as a people, we haven't set down and really focused on it and broke down and make sure that our kids are going to have something. Because from what I see, the bank is taking grandmom's house. That's I'm from Philly, yo. I'm from Philly. Everybody's grandmom house, the bank came and gripped that joint up. It's gone, yo. They done turned them joints into condos. They done turned it into College Town. They done gentrified it. Ain't nobody own nothing. Because why? Because we haven't educated ourselves to make sure that never happens to us.
Right.
And then make sure to put some type of infrastructure under us that if our children do come to some sort of battle like that, that they have like some capital to actually fight back.
Yep.
You see what I'm saying? Like, we haven't thought about these things. These are things that are super important. And you know, I saw Pastor Rufus last night in the stream that he did, and he was talking about the unincorporated associations. You know what I'm saying? Just knowing how to set your paperwork up properly so that everybody that is within the unincorporated association has some say and some ownership and some stake in what happens with the property, what happens with the asset. Right. You know, these are things that I have educated myself on. All of my brothers that, you know, that work with us, we done educated ourselves on trust law, unincorporated associations, you know, where to put your assets at, even putting corporations under a trust. You understand? Like, these are things that unincorporated foundations and associations, they work the same, Pastor Rufus. And I, you know, a lot of churches actually operate under that because it's better than a
501
nonprofit, a 501c3.
Yeah,
you know, it kind of operates like a how the Girl Scouts operate.
Yeah,
you know, where they somewhat like a nonprofit, but they able to gather money, raise money, things like that, and you know, they can kind of keep things private. And when I say kind of, you can't just do it just an unincorporated association or unincorporated foundation. You have to have a couple of other entities within it as well. So we not just a bunch of dummies over here. You feel what I'm saying? We got brothers over here that understand and know what to do. It's just the capital is missing. The capital is missing, and the willingness to go beyond just being religious and wanting to open up another church and another church community. We have to go beyond that if we really want to be able to take care of our families until the impending thing that we all are waiting for. When the Almighty Yah and Christ crack open that sky, there's going to be people that got a house that he's going to come and gather and take back into their homeland. And there's going to be people that they ain't got no house. They living in a concentration camp. You understand?
Yep.
Straight up. He's going to gather them up too. And then all I'm saying is, why do you want to wait to go to a concentration camp? Just go deal with your brothers. You know what I'm saying? Some people call them Goshens. You know, this seems simple to me. You feel me?
Absolutely. And I wanted you to touch on that as well, because
Jesus
had been used against us. And I want you to touch on this. And of course, we believe in the Messiah. We know we're not going to argue names and semantics and things like that right now at the moment. I kid you, bring it out.
in scripture, and I know you probably have it on standby already, or if not, you know, I'll give you a moment because I got some things I want to elaborate on. Could you bring it out in scripture how Christ actually commands us to make these type of moves and initiatives to come together? Because I think what we get is I'm waiting on Jesus. I'm waiting on the Lord. I'm waiting on this. I'm waiting on that. You know, I want to put my trust in the Lord. And I don't think people understand the scriptures that well, how the Messiah himself want us. He never said to wait on him. So if you could bring some of that out, I think that'll really start to lift some of the blinders off the people.
And we being hopeful with that one, Bree, but you know, because religion is really a demonic spirit, and it's really hard to break that off of people's minds, you know, once they go so far into it. But like you said, we really are just planting a seed, and you know, absolutely. this that's what this says, you know. There's a lot of people in the chat, they get it, understand it. You know what I'm saying? And then there are some people that don't get it, unfortunately. And that's okay though too, because it's really just a seed. But I want to go to a couple of scriptures that I can present. And this one right here is Genesis. And I wanna say that, you know, everything that we're talking about is according to prophecy, because the Almighty Yah had already told us what was all going to take place anyway. Okay. And it says Genesis 15 and 13, it says, and I'm going to start at verse 12. It says, and when, I'll start at verse 13. Yeah. It says, and when he said unto Abram, know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes on in verse 14, and also that nation whom they shall serve, I will judge. And afterwards shall they come out with great substance. Right?
Now let's stop this. Oh, man. It didn't say that we were going to come out broke, hurt, destroyed, you know, just totally intent cities and great
not at all.
After the 400 years, we would come out in great substance.
Right. Now peep this though. This is the thing that's, when I saw this, I thought this was amazing, but we know who Abram is, right? That's Abraham, right? But this was before his name was even Abraham. His name was just Abram at the time.
Right.
And he didn't have any children. Abraham didn't have any children when the Almighty Yah told him this, right? Mm-hmm. So when he told him this, Yah was telling him that, yeah, your kids is going to be afflicted 400 years. Mm-hmm. They're going to be afflicted 400 years. And after that, I'm going to judge the nations, and that your children are going to come out with great substance, right? So we already know, like, this right here is a part of the Almighty Yah's plan. We know that, right? You know, so when it comes down to what it is that we are supposed to be doing, well, you know, I mean, it's real, real simple. When we go to Zephaniah.
Yep. And everybody in the chat, if y'all can, please pound that like button if you're learning something right now. If you can literally feel the religious bondage being broke from you, and you actually understanding the initiative further, you know, like the video, share it, push it through the algorithm. And also hit a one in the chat as well to make sure everything is streaming properly and all of that too, because those ones help keep the stream flowing, because it's interaction, it's engagement. All right, continue, Elder.
Yeah, so this is Zephaniah 2 and 1, which you go through with your audience often. But it says right here, gather yourselves together. Mm-hmm. You know, he's not telling us to wait for him to come and gather us together.
Yep.
You know, because literally that concept goes against the whole scriptures. Why? Because aren't we supposed to come together in love? Isn't that what the premise of the whole Bible is about? So think about it. If we're not able to gather ourselves together in love, then are you really worthy of the kingdom? Are you really worthy of the new heavens and the new earth? That's really what you should be asking yourself. If you got hatred in your brother because of what he believes, and you're not able to gather with him because he just may not believe it the exact way that you believe it, something is really wrong. Something is really wrong where this here oppressor has brought you over here and put a book in the midst of us, the Bible, and got us hating one another, causing strife and division with one another. That literally goes against the premise of the whole entire Bible. It makes no sense.
Right. And I'm gonna say this, Elder, it's even deeper because you got camps that believe in the same thing, one West, and they be in the streets literally going to war like the damn Warriors fighting. Y'all don't know if y'all seen that 1980s Warriors, but they be out there fighting. I'm talking about throwing hands. So it shows you it ain't got so wicked with the spirit of religion that, I mean, literally they didn't form gangs out of this, y'all.
Right.
And they supposed to believe in the same damn thing, y'all. So it's something deeper than that. Ego gets in the way when you bring in this religion into, you know, us gathering, and you allowing that to interrupt based on doctrinal differences and beliefs, this is going to be the product. And I'm telling you, 10 times out of 10, that's the product, man. It's religion.
As you can see, that particular spirit that we see amongst our brothers, we got to understand where it's rooted from, right? It's rooted from brothers that have been oppressed, that wanted to see their freedom, and that was able to find a solution through the Bible. But all of the pain, all of the hurt came with that too. And that whole entire infrastructure, our brothers that started One West, our elders that started in the One West, it was a lot of pain and hurt that mm-hmm. went through that. And they brought along with them the whole entire infrastructure from religious institutions, right? That were used to continue to hurt us, right? And it's in the cloth, it's in the linen. You know what I'm saying? It's mm-hmm. like you can't. It's hard to divide it from one from the other. Now, as you can see, some of our brothers that are in camps today, they have learned to deviate from some of those things from one West camps, right? Because they understand that they didn't have it all right. Those brothers didn't have it all right, but they still carrying the same essence, so to speak, mm-hmm. where it does cause division, right? And so when you read a scripture like this in Romans 16, right, and 17, it says, "Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them," right?
Mm-hmm.
"For they that are such serve not our Lord Christ, but their own belly, and by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple." What? I mean, this right here is so simple. You know what I'm saying? And what is it? What is it that we've learned? What did we learn? Doctrine. What is the doctrine that we learned?
Yep.
What is the doctrine that we learned that we should be living according to? Love, right? Yep. Gathering ourselves together. Don't we know this? Mm-hmm. Don't we know this, that a house divided can't stand? We know this already. It's nothing hard to fathom, right? So gather yourselves together. Yeah, gather together, O nation not desired, before the decree bring forth, before the day pass as the shaft. I just want y'all to understand. Before the decree, what mm-hmm. decree? What day pass as the shaft, right? And he's going to show you. He says, "Before the fierce anger of the Almighty Yah come upon you." So before the fierce anger of the Almighty Yah come upon us, right? These are, as some people like to say, the Judah's trouble.
Yeah.
Right. The nations coming up against us, keeping us oppressed. Right. The Almighty Yah is telling us we need to come together. We need to come together even in the midst of that, before his fierce anger come upon us. So right. it's no different than a parent. A parent ain't going, if you at home fighting with your brothers and your sisters, y'all out in the middle of the street boxing it up, embarrassing your parents' home. Y'all right. better get all of that squared away before mom and dad come back. You see what I'm saying? You're not gonna right. because by the time dad come home and you still fighting with your brother, you still fighting with your sister, what's gonna happen to both of y'all? Y'all both getting judgment. So exactly. This right here that we hear people say that how can two walk together unless they agree? Well, who is the two that's supposed to be walking together? And I'm gonna go to that now, right? Because a lot of people use this particular scripture to justify us not gathering together and us not walking together.
Right.
But it does. That's not what the scripture is saying. Actually, it's taken completely out of context because you got to know who's speaking and who's being spoken to. That's first and foremost. So Amos 3, right? And this is what a lot of people go to say, hey, you know what I'm saying? We don't believe the same. So how can we walk together? Well, let's go ahead to that then. This is Amos 3. It says, hear this word that the Almighty Yah has spoken against you. So mm-hmm. this is the Most High speaking against you, the children of Israel, right? He says, O children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up out of the land of Egypt, saying, you, only you have I known of all families of the earth. So our father is literally telling us, like, yeah, you're the people. I only chose you. I'm focused on you. Out of mm-hmm. everybody on the earth, I'm focused on you. I brought you out of the land of Egypt. He's talking to us. He says, therefore, I will punish you for your iniquities. Can two walk together except they be agreed? You know why Yah said that to us? Because we chose to walk against him. And how do we walk against him? When we walk against each other.
Yep.
And then we walk contrary to our father. How do we walk contrary to our father? We walk contrary to our father every single day when we lay our lives on the line for these other nations, and we don't do nothing for ourselves.
Absolutely. And to be clear, a lot of people in these camps and organizations and religious people in general use this scripture to sow more discord because they're not right. reading it properly.
Right.
And they, when they hear that, can two walk together except they be agreed, you thinking, oh, well, that he believe in New Moon Sabbath. Oh, they believe in this feast day being on that day. Oh, this one believe in that. And you literally let that stop you from building with your people because you didn't rightfully divide the word. Like the elder said, if you reading and you following these precepts, it's telling you, can two walk together except he be agreed? It's talking about our relationship with him as well as our relationship with each other. How can we come together if we're sowing discord through frivolous debates, doctrine, and we are striving with one another? It's impossible. So you got to understand what's being said in these scriptures. And, you know, this is the truth. And we got to put away the religion. We got to put away the dissension, the frivolous debate. And the Bible also tells you to avoid certain strivings and things of that nature, which we can go all day on this scripturally. Of course, we're not going to do that. But I did want the elder to bring out some scriptures so y'all can see how this brother breaks the Bible down in case you want to go support him on his channel over there, Congregation of the Mighty. And I really oblige y'all to subscribe to the brother's channel if you really like these in-depth studies and his research and what the brother's doing. Because listen, it ain't just on myself. Me and this brother stand together. And if you reaching out to him about being a part of what we're doing, you reaching out to me as well. Like, don't pigeonhole the brothers in this truth. There's a lot of brothers in this truth that you can reach out to and get in contact with. But as you can see, his channel is in the description box there. I think I'm gonna hit around a 2-hour mark. We are almost there. So if there's any questions in the chat that y'all would like to ask, feel free. We can do these last 5 minutes just for Q&A. If you got questions for myself or the elder.
Yeah. No. I appreciate you bringing me on yet again, Breed. You know what I'm saying? Like, I tell the people all the time, like, you know, this particular work, I don't see that we would have been able to get as far as we've gotten if y'all hadn't allowed you to put it on your heart to, you know, promote, you know, such a thing. You know what I'm saying? We will be still talking about, you know, different problems that we're facing in the world and not really focused on solutions. So I'm just grateful that the Almighty Yah has put it on your heart, you know, to really want to take this to the next level, to make sure that the people know that this is what's possible. This is what's right. possible when we're able to work together.
And I appreciate that, fam. And just thank you for always being involved in this type of work, far as kingdom and nation building, because, you know, the Most High, he puts the right key players in line to get certain things done for his benefit. There's a question here. It says, how are you going to let go of religion? You're still reading from the Bible, Quran, et cetera. Bible, let me answer that for him. The Bible is not a quote unquote religious book. It's actually a history book of your people.
Yeah.
If you of the diaspora, but it's a history book. Anyone who labels themselves a scholar have reading the Bible. You can't call yourself a scholar regardless of what you believe if you're not looking at the most historically relevant book in the world. You know what I'm saying? And that's regardless of religion. You know what I'm saying? We don't deal with religion over here. And being an Israelite, for the record, as well, is a nationality. Right. Thus, nation over religion. So the Bible is a history book of our nationality, not a religion.
Right.
It does give us code of conducts. It is a manual for how we should be living our lives, but it's not a religious book. All right. Now, I know it's been labeled that way, but no, we understand. We decoded that. Is there any more questions?
Yeah. You know, it's funny because a lot of these people that just focus on science and education, they have turned that into a religion.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So this is just, like you said, our historical book, our historical records. And I got something else up on the screen too.
Is it music playing?
No. Okay. It's the next stream that I'm going to be doing. You know, I'm gonna be elaborating on this a little bit more, family. I discussed this a lot on my channel, and you know, it's coming to a point now where we're gonna really have to make a decision to, you know, completely back away from these religious institutions and really focus on cleaning up house. You know, that's what I focus on my channel. You know, gathering men together that really want to get something done at the end of the day. And for people that, you know, as I say, want to play religion, you know what I'm saying? There's places for all of that. You know, there's plenty of channels for all of that. Yeah, we are able to go over the scriptures because we understand that this is our history book. And if you can't learn from history, then you just bound to make the same mistakes. And so I'm glad that we have this here book, this here manual that's able to allow us to see the mistakes that our ancestors made. And it's clear to me that we're still making the same kind of mistakes now today. And you know, so I appreciate it again, Breed, you having this discussion over you know, about nation over religion, because it's really needed for our people right now. They, as you can see, based on that question, you know, a lot of our people truly don't understand. They do look at our history book as a religious book. And then they use, and what has been done is religion has been weaponized against us. And that's really what we need to have our brothers stand up against.
Absolutely. And let me see. I seen a couple questions in the chat, and let me see if I can get to those. I seen one up here. Somebody asked about work visas. Do we plan on doing something regarding visas? I don't see it no more. All right, so we have a donation here, and it says, Hezekiah says, Shalom, brothers. Great conversation. Given the context of the discussion, I wanted to ask New Breed if he remembers saying he doesn't want non-Messianics around him, and whether that is still true today. That's a great question, brother. When it comes to what's being built, let me just put it, preference it this way. when it comes to business and what's being built, I don't care what you believe in. Meaning, let me give you an example. If, let's say hypothetically, all the brothers don't want nothing to do with what we're building here, which that's a real strong hypothetical that ain't gonna take place. But let's say that's the case, right? I will outsource everything. I would just work with all the other nations. Now, by that logic, it means I'm about my business at the end of the day. I'm about the Father's business at the end of the day. Now, the reason you asked me that question is because, and I'm going to make this public again, I'm not a part of the UNY. So when I made those statements, I was directly talking. I'm telling you, I was directly talking to the non-Masonics who was part of that organization. And I'm going to tell you why. Because the way that situation played out, in my opinion, I would rather not deal with too many of those people. That's my opinion. That's how I look at it. So let me just make it clear. If it's a non-Masonic, bro, I don't know what these people believe in. If it's business involved, I don't even care. And the elder makes a point earlier by saying, you know, when he came to the land, it wasn't a question whether what do you believe in or what you don't believe in. He was like, look, I'm just trying to bring my people together and do what needs to be done. So in that hindsight, hopefully I answered that question direct enough for you to get where I'm coming from. When it comes to this business, doctrinal beliefs is not going to stand in the way of what's being built. It won't stand in the way. It can't stand in the way. Because what's being built is not a religion. It's not a church. We're talking about a real community. Now you personally, brother, because I know the reason the question was asked. You personally, if you want to be a part of it, then I'm not stopping you. You know what I'm saying? If you have something that you want to bring to the table, I respect you. You just sent me a contribution. If you want to be a part of what's being built, and I'm not personally saying stop, but if you took offense to the fact that I didn't want to build with those guys, because it is what it is. I have my personal reasons, which I keep offline right now. But, you know, if anybody from that organization want to call me and speak to me behind the scenes, then I'm free. I will definitely answer why I'm saying I'm not a part of the UNY boldly to them personally without putting nothing online. But you personally, you was a part of the initiative. If you still want to be a part of it, be a part of it. But this is not a religious institution. Ain't nobody starting no churches. Ain't nobody trying to lead. Ain't nobody trying to be the leader. It's not like an organization where we having meetings just to have Bible study. That's not what's about to happen. We about to really build something.
Right. Yep. And I did see a couple of other questions I just wanted to address. Our sister Nicole Wilson, she said, if we put in the religion aside, should we strive for holiness? You know, I'm just going to say this. Us being set apart has nothing to do with religion. Religion is a man-made institution. Mm-hmm. You know, it's made by men. The Most High never created a religion. Like, you're not going to go through the whole entire text and see anything in there about a particular religion that our Father is asking us to be a part of. If man has made religion and we are supposed to be holy, which means set apart, aren't we supposed to be set apart from religion?
Yeah. Yep. Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah. And then this question from New Glyph, one of your members, shout out to New Glyph. Can we, the people, own a part of the land, not just rent? This is a great question. So the people already own the land. What I mean by that is that the land will always be an inheritance of the people, as long as we are, you know, a part of the land. Now, what does ownership mean to you? Does it mean that you have a piece of paper that says that plot of land is yours and that you can sell it and do whatever you want to do? That will never happen, because we can't afford to have people. And again, this is not my land. I didn't purchase the land. You know what I'm saying? if I went and purchased the land, then I can own all the land that I want. This is the wishes of the brother that purchased the land. He wants to keep this land open for all of the people as long as you know, we're able to take care of it. You know what I'm saying? And so are you going to be renting the land? No, you're not going to be renting the land, but the land has costs that are involved. There's taxes on the land, which we will be working on making sure that we don't have to pay any tax on this land. But there's other things on the land that we are all going to be collectively paying for together. But the home that you build on that land, you own. Whatever assets or businesses you create on that land, you own. So just think, if you create a business over there that's generating $500,000 a year, that's your money.
Yeah,
that's your money. You can go take that money and go buy your own land. Mm-hmm. You could do whatever you want. You know what I'm saying? So if somebody right now told me, yo, I got some free land that mm-hmm. you could go ahead and build whatever you want to build on and start a business, do whatever you want. Yo, yep. I'm out.
Right.
And that's what I did. I left Pennsylvania and moved down here close to the land. And mm-hmm. as soon as I get my paper right, I'm building something on that land. I'm stacking right. my money up, and then I'm going to go buy my own land.
Right.
And I can own as much land as I want because I bought it.
Yeah. And, so, and I'm glad you brought that out, Elder, too, because I keep saying we need to be about our business. And the fact that you brought that out puts a different perspective and shine a different light on the power of having land. I want y'all to envision we having some type of gathering there. We having an event. And you just got something like a food truck. Like, you're generating business revenue on that said land. Now you have leverage. So if you did want to negotiate something, then you can cross that bridge there. Or like the brother said, you can go buy your own piece of land. The plot, the land itself generates revenue. So you got to, when we say, yo, it's about business, change your mind for the moment. Focus on your business. You understand? So I'm so glad you brought that out, because I keep saying it, but you know, I really want people to let that register. It brings business. Yeah. And that's what your mind got to be on. It's a lot of things that we didn't know that we know now when it comes to generating revenue. We didn't know nothing about LLCs and all these things that these brothers are educated on. And I'm not the most educated on all of that stuff, right? But I do know what makes sense. And right. It makes sense to generate that revenue and take advantage of some of the knowledge of the brothers around me. See, I'm wise enough to know that I got good brothers around me. And when I need advice, and that's what it's about. That's why it's no one man above this. Everybody's skilled in different areas. And so, yeah, man, just being in the presence of righteous men with wisdom, you are bound to be abundant in every way. And that's why the scriptures tell us when there's no leadership, the people fall. You know, there's no protection. Being amongst just some of you younger brothers out there taking the opportunity to come to the land walks, to come to the events, you're going to be amongst greatness. And the right. fact that you're among greatness, guess what? There's unlimited potentials.
Yeah.
There's unlimited potential. So just get your mind on your business and everything yeah. else. When the capital come, when the revenue come, because the scriptures say we leave this captivity plenteous, we be abundant. Keep your mind on that abundancy. And right. then when the time come, hey, we be buying land all over America, man. Don't limit ourselves.
And it's really just monopoly, you know what I'm saying? Because mm-hmm. should anyone really be owning land, or is this a European construct
mm-hmm.
of capitalism, a European construct of colonialism? That's purely what it is. We didn't make this game. So for the person that's in the chat that was saying to purchase with USD and binding contract codes, we didn't make this game and didn't make this system, but we are praying against it.
Yeah.
When I say we are praying against it, we're praying that the Almighty Yah frees the whole planet from colonialism. From right. this captivity, so that not one person has to worry about if they have to go buy land. That doesn't even make sense. Like, how many of you have taken a drive and you could see land on land on land on land. You just passing by all of this land, and I dare you to go ahead and start trying to build a little house over there. They going to come and tell you, you got to go. They going to lock you up. You're going to get fined, all that kind of stuff. So, you know, that was another great question. The women.
What is the woman part in this building work? What is the woman's part in the building work? Yeah. Well, there's women with various skills and trades as well. I mean,
there's a sister on the land.
We just talked about this earlier, how, you know, there's women who like, what's the sister's name who you said she built her own community?
Oh, what's Sister Brown. Yep, Sister Brown. She Elaine Brown. She's a ex Black Panther, and she just built a whole entire 76 unit low income property. It got farming on there. It got tech workshops. I mean, you name it. This woman went ahead and did that. She saw all of these people online talking. Yep. She saw all the talking heads. She saw Oprah and all those people when she said, them ninjas ain't doing nothing. I'm going to go build something for the people. And you know what the name of that building is? It's called the Black Panther, yo. And the lady is hilarious. Yo, it's called the Black Panther, bro. I lied to you not. She's about to be launching, this spring she's launching that building. So it's amazing what our sisters, you know, are able to do. You know what I'm saying? When they feel like doing it. Our sisters feel like, and that's, it said a virtuous woman, she going to see land, and she going to go ahead and purchase it, and she going to build upon it. Exactly. That's what it said the virtuous woman going to do.
So, for the record, we're not limiting women being involved, y'all. We're not doing that at all. Some of y'all ladies, y'all just know how to talk. Y'all can get us in the door with certain things, because we might got too much dirt under our nails or be a little too rough around the edges with our delivery, and like, yo, let's send Sister So-and-so in here to communicate, because, you know, it is what it is, you know? So don't think
sisters know how to do them books too. They know how to do, they know how to do that accounting. Shoot, we got sisters out there that got degrees. They real smart. You know what I'm saying? They know how to do things that a lot of our brothers are not going to put in the work to do. We really just need each other. We need to work together to get the paperwork right. But if a sister wanted to go and build a little house over there, she could do that too. Get a little chicken coop out there, a little garden, and you good. I mean, you know, what we are planning to do together is just some community spaces, right? But your own personal house and what you decide to do on your plot and space, that's your business. Now, whatever brother can come and help you out, whatever sisters want to come help you out with what you're doing, you know what I'm saying? That's just how we're going to be moving. But there are some more communal spaces that we are looking to build over there, like some bathroom huts, some shower stations, right? Some community spaces where people can have offices. People can, have different things for their businesses, you know, cook places to cook, things like that. Those are the communal spaces that we're going to have, because it is going to have like a resort type feel. In the beginning, because it is a business overall. So people are going to be coming with RVs, people are going to be coming with tents, and then they can just go take a shower. They can go in the little office section. They can, you know what I'm saying, build with the people there. That's going to have to we're going to have to collectively bring our resources together to make sure to build that out, so that anybody that comes to the land has what they need, the basis of what they need to do what they could do.
Absolutely. And the answer to the question, yes, Bridget. Yes. You know, it's being shipped over. She has to own the yurt. Yeah, it's not being rented or nothing like that. Because they're not as expensive as one going to get buy a home and build it. You know, I don't have those type of resources at the moment to be doing that. But yes, and it'll be something that once y'all see it built, I'm hoping that y'all be influenced and inspired to get you one built. And I can tell you the whole process of it, and it'll be easier to build yours than it was to build mine. You know what I'm saying? So absolutely. And I'm calling it mine right now, but let's be real. We want this land to develop to the point where the kids just going to be using the yurt. All the kids in the neighborhood going to be using the yurt for some type of gazebo or something, little play. Like, we want this to be big. So, you know, that'll end up being something that's there. Like, I want to look back and be like, yo, you remember all we had was that yurt up? You know what I mean?
Right.
And now the kids just playing in it. Now, you know, people, you know, that's the office somebody using or something. We got great visions for everything. So
yeah, I mean, there's things that we've talked about that a lot of people, you know, some people here are gonna be like, yo, they really thinking big. There's a whole city around the corner that's an abandoned city.
Yeah,
I'm like, it ain't gonna take much for us to buy up that whole city and do whatever we want to do with it.
Mm-hmm.
This is not, to me, it's like we're beyond thinking about the land. That's just a couple of acres. We like, yo, can we buy a whole town for ourselves? And the answer is yes. The answer is absolutely yes. And as far as the question that was just asked about the yurt, I just want to present my screen one more time, Bree. Okay, I appreciate the extra time you.
No, not a problem. Not a problem. Because we want the people's questions answered. And again, ladies and gentlemen, if y'all have questions, y'all need to ask them now.
This right here is Alibaba.com, and I'm just giving it to y'all real raw and uncut. Why? Because I don't want to go order your yurt. I don't want New Breed to have to go order your yurt. I don't want to have to do all of the little intricate details, because something go wrong, then you like, oh, your wits is out. He messed it up. He took my money. No, you go talk to the people at Alibaba, right? This is where we got New Breed's yurt from, okay? And his is not going to look exactly like this. His
mine gonna be navy blue, y'all, and it's gonna have a New Breed door on it. As they did a custom, they did like a custom job on it, so it's gonna be tight.
Exactly. And so as you can see, the prices vary on this, and I would definitely recommend that, you know. And I'm not saying this particular one on the site, you know what I'm saying? There are other ones on the site that you could look at, but you know. Pretty much what I'm saying is this is where we ordered New Breed's yurt from Alibaba.com. And there is a lot of different livable structures here that, you know, you could potentially put on the land. I mean, mm-hmm. like they got all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. So, we definitely don't want to do no tents and things like that, because that's not going to be sustainable out there. But do your own shopping. Nobody here should have to shop for you. Do your own shopping. Do some research. You feel what I'm saying? Look, you can come over here. You be like, yo, I really like this right here. Is this something that could be sustainable on the land? That's a good question. You could come and ask us that. We'll take a look at it and be like, you know what? Yeah, that'll definitely work. Okay. And we got somebody that speak their language. Not everybody over here from Alibaba speaks English. We got my cousin. He speaks Cantonese, so he's the one that helped New Breed get his yurt, because he speaks their language. You see what I'm saying? So like I said, we not just some dummies over here. We getting it done, and we figuring it out and utilizing the people that know how to do a thing or two. You know what I'm saying? So
absolutely,
this is not hard. I mean, could you imagine if we go on YouTube, Breed, because you, I mean, any one of you out there, right? If you wanted to start a YouTube channel, you could start a YouTube channel just based off of buying something like this right here.
Yep.
Be like, hey guys, so welcome to my YouTube channel. I just bought this house from China. We're gonna check this out, open this thing up. You could go viral overnight just off of this right here.
Yeah,
because nobody here is doing that. You know what they're doing? They renting, they renting, and they going to the bank and getting scammed. That's what they're doing.
Exactly. And look at that. That look nice.
That look excellent.
And it's his. Excellent. He own it. It's his. All he needs is the brand to put it.
You see what they doing, right, Bree? They say 1 to 9 sets of this for $5,000.
That, man. And all he needed is some land to put it on. You know, and he good. You see that?
I mean, this, to me, this, it just makes sense to me. Like, I'm like, I'm just like, yo, if we got people with huge channels that's making, you know what I'm saying, making decent money, we can all the YouTubers can go together. Like, I mean, what's that YouTuber? He went to Africa and he hooked them up with water. He hooked up all the water over there in Africa. Mr. Beast.
Mr. Beast. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Mr. Beast. Just that random dude. He don't read the Bible. He not religious at all. Dude, is he?
Nope.
But he went over there to Africa and made sure that they got water over there in multiple places. And all we asking to do is like, yo, can we just build some communities with stuff like this? Imagine if we had 10 YouTubers that say, you know what, let's all put our money together and get 20 of these on the land. Bro, we can do it overnight. And that's really why this here is one of the most important streams that you did, bro, because it really is calling out all of the brothers that are putting out the message that the people need to hear and now giving that solution. And so yeah, Mr. Beast is a straight up devil anyway.
Yeah.
We're not
his name. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, but that's tight right there. I like that.
I mean, it's a lot of good stuff on here, man. I it was a young brother that reached out to me. He was looking at stuff like this right here, like this dome joint. He said, "I think I want to get one of those." I'm like, "Go for it, bro. Go for it." I mean, this stuff is amazing.
That look cool.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, hey, man. So can we do it? Can we do it? Sisters, can we do it? I know we can do it. If we just get up out of religion, we will start thinking about business real quick and get straight to work.
Real talk. Pardon me. And is there any more questions before we close out? Yeah, that's fly right there.
Right. See that's you see how they got the platform, right? They got that whole platform there. It's like a whole wooden platform,
right?
Standing up off the ground. And they could put whatever they want on top of there. They could have put a yurt. They could put this thing. You can even build a small home on top of that, John.
Right.
I mean,
man, that's cool.
Could you imagine?
I'm over here looking at it like I might have to get one of those in the future, man.
Hey, Bree, imagine putting this on Airbnb.
Man, what?
You see people talking about, can I own? What you want to own? You want to put it on Airbnb.
And make your money.
My goodness.
You know, you'll
I mean, it. This right here for Airbnb, I would say this would probably go for like $200-$300 a
night,
just a night, and it's only an hour away from Myrtle Beach. Like man, people would be like, "Yo, I'm definitely over there. I'm going to UP Farms.
Exactly.
I'm going to Unlimited Potential Farms. They got farm to table food. They got this beautiful glamping. You know, an hour from the beach. Come on, y'all, we gotta think big, bro."
Man, what?
What are we waiting on, man? I've been waiting over a year, bro. I just like, you know what? I guess it's just gonna be me and New Breed at the end of the day.
Hey, I hope not. I hope all of you know we got some brothers in the network. That's some big brothers in this. But yo, man, I hope the people really see what's going on here. When them scriptures say we will leave in abundance, man, I'm talking about. And this is just for the camping, you know. Kind of getaway type of stuff, but man, it's even gonna be bigger than this. But this is a beautiful start. I think this is a beautiful start. Yeah, it's a good start, man. So yeah. I mean, hopefully, I don't see too many more questions. So I guess we answered all the questions. If there is any more questions, y'all got a couple minutes to do it. But I mean, it's self-explanatory.
Could you imagine us having an event like this joint on the land?
Man, what? Absolutely,
bro. We order one of these and just have a big event on the land. You know what I'm saying? Just have all of the YouTubers come out, music artists come out. You know what I'm saying? We One Love, 1 Million Strong Festival.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then all the, you know, make sure that the proceeds go towards just building more infrastructure on the land. Like this is.
Exactly.
And this is the, to me, family, I'm like, yo, why can't we do it? Why
somebody can't we said do for the person says everyone is asking where is it? It's in North Carolina, but we're not giving them direct coordinates online for obvious reasons. It's an hour away from Myrtle Beach. That should answer your question. We're not gonna give the direct coordinates. It's a piece of land, so it's not like you know. But no,
which is North Carolina.
It's North Carolina.
North Carolina, hour from Myrtle Beach, and yeah, I mean, you know, we want to be able to give people coordinates. We do. I mean, one day that is going to be open for the public and you just going to have to come in come and get, you know, put your money down on whatever space you're going to be staying at for a couple of days. Because by the time we launch this thing, the people that's going to be living there is going to be living there. It's not going to be too much more space, but just for visitors. You know what I'm saying?
So, Abby says, will there be fellowship events on the land? Absolutely. Like, you know, meet and greets and different events of that nature. Mike, the land purchaser, he already does jamborees. And I mean, I could see us doing movie nights, you know what I'm saying? Using a projector monitor, like something like a drive-in movie type stuff. You know, like different things will be happening on that land, like real innovative things that just they're not really doing. Like your average YouTubers, that they're not even thinking about doing stuff like what we're going to put together. So a lot of stuff is going to be a surprise. And y'all be like, oh, that's dope. I'm going to show up for that. You know what I'm saying? So,
I mean, look, we got people talking about they want to come and shoot movies on the land.
That
so
part
we,
too.
You know what I mean? We're going to be having the studios. Like literally in that paperwork that I showed, all of that is in the plan as ways that we could generate capital. And, you know, it's just about doing it. Somebody said, our whites welcome.
Yes, man. You welcome over here, right? Just like you over here, you could be on the land, bro.
I just came back from one of their festival events. You know, they had jazz and food. I didn't have to ask, was I welcome? Because ain't nobody over there dealing with religion. They just, hey, come and spend your money.
And for the brother in the chest, say, y'all need a mini hotel, motel for visitors and bring some income. Hey, for everybody saying y'all need, I want y'all to change the way y'all talk. We need. Right. We need. I want y'all to like feel like y'all in this, man. We in this together. So
right.
But I agree with you. We're gonna have something like that too. But it's we need. Because that shows me that you're a part of what's being built. Because I hear that a lot. Y'all gonna do this, y'all gonna do that. I want to hear we gonna do this. Can we should have that, and we should. I gotta know y'all understanding where we going with this.
Yeah, because if it keep being about us doing it, then people gonna be thinking that we are leaders of it. I just want to just live there like y'all. Like I don't want to do all this work, man.
Exactly.
hey Bree, can you put that on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this is the plot of land right here. All of this here that you see, all the way back into those trees, all the way back into these trees, that's all the land. So I mean, as you can imagine how big this must be, because you can see small buildings in the distance there. Yep. So you know that's a nice size community, family. Yeah, and it's all for us to do whatever we want to do on it, and you know. It's going to be a public space. We're going to have public spaces there. There's going to be some private places where people are going to be living at. There's going to be some farm to table, you know, restaurants. There's going to be entertainment spaces. It's going to be all that. It's just whatever it is that we decide that we want to do.
Yeah.
But I could tell you this, if it's just going to be on me and New Breed, then I'm going to help New Breed get his yurt. I'm gonna order my yurt, and I'm gonna just stay out there and go camping every year. That's all I'm gonna do. Yeah. So that's it.
Real talk.
I'm gonna just being real with y'all. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of potential for real. Exactly, Brother Mike.
For sure. So somebody said, is there a PO box address we can send supplies and resources?
Not yet. I mean, we do have an address. The thing is. Like right now, we need a storage container. So there's two storage containers on there now. And the brother that purchased the land, those are his containers. And so we have to order a container. And then once we have a container, then we can allow people to donate, you know, tools and things like that. But for the most part, if people have things that you really want us to have, you know, if it's within our means, we can pick it up and take it to the land. But we really don't have anywhere to store anything. So like all of the farming supplies, you know, building supplies, you know what I'm saying? Like that, like we're at a deficit right now. We're trying to, you know, just every little thing matters. Like we got a guard dog on the land now. We got security on the land now because somebody can easily come to the land and try to take things. So it's the simple things that we haven't all thought about collectively that has to be thought about. I don't want to have a bunch of expensive stuff over there and not have people over there looking after it. You feel what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, let's say you give me a bunch of supplies. This here town is one of the is a very low income town. There's a lot of poor people there, so they see you coming over there flexing. They like, man, I'm trying to make a come up. I need to eat. You know what I'm saying? So what we're trying to do is make sure we can create jobs over there for the people. We can create opportunities for the people that live in that community and secure our stuff.
Right. Yeah, that's absolutely right on point. Yes, sir. Somebody says, I'm down with for this. How do we get in touch? I'm in Charlotte. Well, we shared newbreed.love. There's a link on there where you can pretty much fill out an application to. And we're in a building process. So this is if you want to be involved in the development stages, meaning you have a certain skill, you have a certain trade, you know,
or an investor.
Yep. Or an investor. Newbreed.love. Fill out the information. And then from there, you know, we'll have your information and we can put you in the WhatsApp group. And for all the brothers that's in the WhatsApp group, I'm going to be going over there pretty soon, doing some cleaning up over there. If you just in there sending instrumentals and beats and music and listen, I understand you brothers are
you want a fellowship.
You want a fellowship. I'm cool with that. And I'm not trying to be too stringent on you brothers in there, but we are there for a purpose. And what I expect when I look in that WhatsApp group, what I expect to see is something going towards the mission. You understand? Information. You can share YouTube links. You can share different things, but it has to be information towards what we're building. If you're in there throwing instrumentals and all of that kind of stuff in there, you're going to show yourself not to be a part of what's being built. It's like you don't know what the group is for. So I'm warning you, clean it up. I don't want to have to remove people out of the group because I interviewed a great deal of you brothers, and I know y'all's intentions are good, right?
Yeah. Hey, man. Hey, listen, this is a great stream, Breed, because it really shows the people like everything that you've been talking to the people about, warning the people about, that we are actually putting forth the work to make to prepare for such events.
Absolutely.
I mean, this is no better preparation. You know what I'm saying? It's like you got land. Go ahead and start building on it. Stack up. You know what I mean? And while everything is crashing down around you, you're going to be all right. You know what
Absolutely.
I mean?
Absolutely.
If y'all chooses that, actually, you know what I'm saying? So.
Right.
Yeah.
And I'm glad you were able to put these visuals to show the people what was really going on. And if we can, I don't know if you got any editing software, but this specific portion of the stream, we need to upload that as just a regular video. Like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, on all our platforms, all the things that has been shared, because you know some people don't have the attention span to catch a 2.5-3 hour stream. So I'm gonna make sure I dish that out to y'all through uploads where y'all can see, you know. But yeah, man,
I highly recommend people, you know, just go over to my channel.
Yep.
You know, I'm gonna do a quick stream as well in a bit. And, you know, we're going to continue on talking on this here time. Hopefully those brothers checked out the stream. I saw it get kind of quiet from some of the brothers because it is a long stream. But hopefully they catch this stream and, they see that it's something that they want to get involved with. So shout out to all of those brothers. And, you know, I pray that we can definitely get beyond, you know, all the hurt and the pain that religion has caused us. And just focus on really building for our people, for our children, and you know, making a real difference. Appreciate you, Bree.
Thank you, brother. Thank you. And hey, man, it's always a blessing building with you, man. And for those who wondering, man, we got more music coming because I think somebody asked that earlier. Yeah,
all man, the music
it's coming. It's coming. It's coming. But thank you. I appreciate your time. And y'all go subscribe to the brother and catch his stream. You know what I'm saying? All right, y'all. Peace and blessings. Till next time. With that being said, shalom and peace.
Shalom.